فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. We stopped in the explanation of أسباب الأمور المعينة على الصبر على أذى الخلق. Things that aid you and support you in attaining patience from the harms of the creation. We stopped at the fourth one, from the 20 ways that the Shaykh mentions. We are on the fourth, so we've got 16 to go, inshallah ta'ala, including this one. It would be 17. الرابع, the fourth. أن يشهد, the fourth way to gain patience towards the harm of the creation is أن يشهد, that the person, he bears witness أنه إذا عفا وأحسن, that if he forgives and he comes with excellence, أورثه ذلك من سلامة القلب لإخوانه, this will automatically inherit him a pure heart towards his brothers. ونقائه من الغش والغل, and it would also purify from him jealousy, envy, treachery, treachery, to be treacherous towards his brothers. وطلب الانتقام, and it will also purify from him the want to retaliate and wanting evil for the people. It will purify him from all of that. So if the person realizes that if he forgives and he comes with excellency, automatically that will inherit him, inshallah ta'ala, that his heart is going to be pure towards his brothers, and he will be purified from having al-ghishi, cheating, and being treacherous, and also wanting retaliation and revenge and evil towards his brothers. All of that will go. وحصل له من حلاوة العفو ما يزيد لذته, and also he will gain the sweetness that forgiveness has. ما يزيد لذته, that sweetness will increase, or that which will increase the sweetness, ومنفعته, and his benefits, عاجلا وآجلا, in this world or in the hereafter. In other words, the benefit that the person will reap and the sweetness that the person will gain is far greater. The benefits in this world and the hereafter is far greater على المنفعة الحاصلة له بالانتقام than the sweetness that he gains when he retaliates and he takes revenge. أضعاف مضاعفة, multiplied your sweetness and the joy that you will gain in this world and the happiness that you will gain and the sweetness that you will gain in forgiving is far more better than the sweetness and the benefits that you will gain in retaliating, taking revenge. And the Shaykh then goes on to say, وَيَدْخُلُ فِي قَوْلِهِ تَعَالَى, and it enters under the verse of Allah, وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ, Allah loves the muhsineen, the righteous ones. So the person becomes فَيَصِيرُ مَحْبُوبًا لِلَّهِ, he becomes beloved to Allah because he's a muhsin now. وَيَصِيرُ حَالُهُ, and then his situation becomes حَالَ مَنْ أُخِذَ مِنْهُ دِرْهَمٌ, and his situation is going to be like one who a dirham was taken from him. And dirham is what? It was a currency that was made out of gold. Dirham is gold, and dinar is what? Dinar is gold, right? And the dirham is silver. I may be wrong in one of the ways. One is gold and one is silver. I think dirham is silver and dinar is gold. It is like a person who a dirham was taken from him. فَعُوِضَ عَلَيْهِ أَلْفًا مِنَ الدَّنَانِيرِ A silver was taken from him, one silver, and it was exchanged for him 1,000 dinar, dananir. 1,000 golds. 1,000, huh? So in other words, the currency is better, and the amount is also more. So your situation is like that. Like as though one dirham was taken from you, and then what was given to you in exchange? فَعُوِضَ عَلَيْهِ أَلْفًا مِنَ الدَّنَانِيرِ 1,000 dinar was given to you. فَحِينَئِذٍ At this moment, يَفْرَحُ بِمَا مَنَّ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ أَعْظَمَ فَرْحًا يَكُونُ Then this, at this point, the person will become so happy and joyful on that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has bestowed upon him. He will be more happier than any other way. So this is very important, this one that the Shaykh rahimahullah is mentioning. That forgiving and letting go is better for your heart. And you know there's a saying which they say, keeping a person in your heart is allowing a person to live in your property without paying rent. Why does this person deserve to be living in your heart for? You're the one who's carrying this stress and this headache. They're probably out there not worried about nothing. So the minute you let go and you forgive, you forget, automatically you have salamatul qalb. Your heart is a state of tranquility. And also, the evil thoughts that were running in your head and the things that you were thinking to yourself to get this person back, to retaliate, revenge, the evil that you wanted for this person will go. And then you will enjoy yourself. In this world, you enjoy yourself because you'll be stressless. You see? And in the hereafter, what awaits for you is greater. Because Allah loves you, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wallahu yuhibbul muhsinin. You're from the muhsinin. You've gained the love of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you're basically, the reason why you will forgive and forget is because whatever this person can do to you in this world, and whatever they can put you through in this world, for forgiving and forgetting and letting go allows you to get better and greater things in the hereafter. So you've exchanged a better value. You've taken a better deal in what you could have gained in this world. Then you're a wise person. The fifth one. The Shaykh rahimahullah, he says, Al-Khamisu, the fifth. And ya'lama, that the person knows. Annahu man taqama ahadun. That you do not ever retaliate or take revenge to a person. You never take a revenge from a person. Qattun whatsoever. لِنَفْسِهِ إِلَّا أَوْرَثَهُ ذَلِكَ ذُلًّا يَجِدُهُ فِي نَفْسِهِ Except that it will inherit you humility, in which you will find in yourself. You feel humiliated in yourself. So the Shaykh is trying to say this point, the first sentence. He's saying that what you need to know is that there is not a person who takes revenge whatsoever for himself, except that this inherits him humiliation, which he finds in internally. فَإِذَا عَفَى But if he forgives, أَعَزَّهُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى Allah honors him. And he goes, وَهَذَا مِمَّا أَخْبَرَ بِهِ الصَّادِقُ الْمَصْدُوقُ And this is what he informed us of, the one who is truthful and the one who has been taken and been considered as truthful. مَا زَادَ اللَّهُ عَبْدًا بِعَفْوٍ إِلَّا عِزًّا. That Allah does not increase a person in forgiveness except honor. In other words, forgiving increases you in honor. But you brothers all know the way that the messenger said it here has a very strong meaning, which is that the ma here is ma nafiyah, negation. And then that negation comes after it what? Harf istithna comes. Illa. Izzan, honor. Meaning is there's, by forgiving you gain nothing except honor from it. فَالْعِزُّ الْحَاصِلُ لَهُ بِالْعَفْوِ. The honor in which a person gains through forgiveness is more beloved to him and is more beneficial for him than the honor he will gain in retaliating or taking revenge. وَأَنْفَعُ لَهُ مِنَ الْعِزِّ الْحَاصِلِ لَهُ بِالْإِنْتِقَامِ. The honor that you gain in forgiving is far more beloved to you and more beneficial for you than the honor, than the benefit, sorry, that you gain, or the honor that you gain from taking revenge. Why? He goes, فَإِنَّ هَذَا عِزٌ فِي الظَّاهِرِ. Because one of them, the one when you take it, the one when you take revenge for yourself, is only an honor that is external. فَإِنَّ هَذَا عِزٌ فِي الظَّاهِرِ. It is honor externally, in the eyes of the people, more like, or in the outer world, you might look honorable. وَهُوَ يُورِثُ فِي الْبَاطِنِ ذُلًّا. But what it inherits you internally is humiliation. وَالْعَفْوُ ذُلٌّ فِي الْبَاطِنِ وَهُوَ يُورِثُ الْعِزَّ بَاطِنًا وَظَاهِرًا. And the Sheikh says that forgiveness inherits internally. And this is based on what? The perception of the people. It's not necessarily. يُظَنُّ فِي مَنْ عَفَى أَنَّ هَذَا ذُلْ. Automatically the people perceive you as a person who is what? Humiliated. وَالْعَفْوُ ذُلٌّ فِي الْبَاطِنِ. But he says, وَهُوَ فِي الْحَقِيقَةِ يُورِثُ الْعِزَّةَ بَاطِنًا وَظَاهِرًا. But he said, in reality, Ibn Taymiyyah said, is that it inherits you honor in externally and internally. It liberates you and frees you from the humum and the wumum. And that is wallahi very powerful. Number six. He said, وَهِيَ مِنْ أَعْظَمِ الْفَوَائِدِ. Ibn Taymiyyah here is now, this one is one from the greatest benefits that are in his speech. This one, very powerful. This is one is from the greatest of benefits, which is أَنْ يَشْهَدَ, that the person bears witness. أَنَّ الْجَزَاءَ مِنْ جِنْسِ الْعَمَلِ, that the reward is in accordance to the actions. وَأَنَّهُ نَفْسُهُ ظَالِمٌ مُذْنِبٌ, that you yourself are an oppressive sinner. وَأَنَّ مَنْ عَفَى عَنِ النَّاسِ عَفَى اللَّهُ عَنْهُ. And anyone who forgives the people, Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala will forgive you. وَمَنْ غَفَرَ لَهُمْ غَفَرَ اللَّهُ لَهُ. And anyone who forgives forgives the people, Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala will forgive you and wipe away from you your shortcomings. فَإِذَا شَهِدَ, if the person bears witness to that, أَنَّ عَفْوَهُ عَنْهُمْ وَصَفْحَهُ وَإِحْسَانَهُ مَعَ إِسَاءَتِهِمْ إِلَيْهِ سَبَبٌ لِأَنْ يُجْزِيَهُ الله كذلك من جنس عمله. He said, if the person testifies that his forgiveness and he's letting go, forgetting. So he's not only forgiving, but he's forgetting it. He's turning a blind eye. And also his wa'ihsanahu, his excellency towards those who have dealt with him in an evil way. مَعَ إِسَاءَتِهِمْ إِلَيْهِ. They've dealt with him in an evil manner. It is a sababun. It will be a reason. It will be a reason for Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala to reward you in accordance to the action of yours. So the way you turned away from their mistake towards you, and you turned a blind eye to it, and you let go of it, even though they are dealing with you in an evil way, then this act of yours is the way Allah is going to deal with you. فَيَعْفُ عَنْهُ. Allah will forgive you. وَيَصْفَحْ. And he will let go. وَيُحْسِنَ إِلَيْهِ عَلَى ذُنُوبِهِ. And Allah tabarak wa ta'ala will be good towards you in the sins that you have done. وَيَسْهُلَ عَلَيْهِ عَفْهُ وَصَبْرُهُ. And Ibn Taymiyyah says, Allah will make it easy for you as well. In your forgiveness towards the people and your patience towards the people. Allah make it easy for you to be able to do it now. Ibn Taymiyyah then says, وَيَكْفِي الْعَاقِلَ هَذِهِ الْفَائِدَةِ. This is sufficient for an intellectual person. A smart person, this one alone is enough for him as a benefit. That he remembers the qa'idah, which is al-jaza'u min jinsi al-amal. That is enough for him to say to himself that I will forgive and forget. So this one helps you definitely a lot. Number seven. As-sabi' number seven. أن يعلم that the person knows. أنه إذا اشتغلت أنه إذا اشتغلت نفسه. That the person knows. إذا اشتغلت نفسه, if your soul busies itself. So the person knows with unwavering conviction that if his nafs, his soul busies itself, بِالِنْتِقَامِ, it busies itself with revenge. And it preoccupies its time with revenge and how to get the person back. وَطَلَبُ الْمُقَابَلَةِ. And he wants to give him in return exactly what he did to him. In other words, revenge. ضَاعَ عَلَيْهِ زَمَانُهُ. Your time will get wasted like that. وَتَفَرَّقَ عَلَيْهِ قَلْبُهُ. And you will divide your heart. And your heart should have been all focused. You lose focus of whatever you're trying to achieve. Your brain should have been focused on something more important. But here what you've done to your heart is you've divided it. And you've also wasted your time. And then Sheikh says, وَفَاتَهُ مِن مَصَالِحِهِ. And also, you miss very beneficial things. مَا لَا يُمْكِنُ اسْتِدْرَاكُهُ. Things that you can never get hold of again. Things that you cannot gain again. Things that you cannot catch up with anymore. You lose everything you could have done in that period of time where you busied your mind and your heart to just think about retaliation and revenge. All you did is you wasted time. You see, you've also lost focus of what you should have been doing. You've made yourself lose opportunities that went by. ولعل هذا أعظم ولعل هذا أعظم أعظم عليه. And he said, because maybe this, ولعل هذا أعظم. And he said, maybe this is greater عليه on the person من المصيبة التي نالته من جهتهم. And maybe it is possible that this becomes greater in calamity than whatever you had endured from the person. This is actually a greater calamity, that you've wasted your time, you've lost focus in life, you've missed opportunities that came by. Maybe that's a greater calamity than what this person put you through. But if you forgive, فَإِذَا عَفَى وَصَفَحَ فَرَغَ قَلْبُهُ وَجِسْمُهُ لِمَصَالِحِهِ الَّتِي هِيَ أَهَمُّ عِنْدَهُ مِنَ الْإِنْتِقَامِ. But if you forget and you let go, then your focus comes back, your mind is there, and your body is ready and prepared for the things that are beneficial for it. Then what? مِنَ الْإِنْتِقَامِ than a revenge. So your mind is there, your body is there, and you're focusing on what's more important in life for you to achieve. Number 8. أَنَّ انْتِقَامَهُ وَاسْتِيفَاءَهُ وَانْتِصَارَهُ لِنَفْسِهِ وَانْتِقَامَهُ لَهَا. That also the person bears witness that your revenge and your retaliation and you bringing yourself honor and victory for yourself, you know and you bear witness what? فَإِنَّ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ مَنْ تَقَمَ لِنَفْسِهِ قَطْ. That the Messenger of Allah never took revenge for himself. So you know and you bear witness that this retaliation and this revenge that you want to come with, and this victory that you want to give to your nafs, that the Prophet of Allah had never, alayhi salatu wasalam, took revenge for himself. فَإِذَا كَانَ هَذَا خَيْرُ خَلْقِ اللَّهِ وَأَكْرَمَهُمْ. If this is the best of creation and the most honorable of the creations of Allah, لَمْ يَنْتَقِمْ لِنَفْسِهِ, never took revenge for himself. مَعَ أَنَّ أَذَاهُ أَذَى اللَّهِ. Even that though, harming the messenger is harming Allah. وَيَتَعَلَّقُ بِهِ حُقُوقَ الدِّينِ. And also, harming the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is a religious duty connected to it. وَنَفْسُهُ, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, soul, أَشْرَفُ الْأَنْفُسِ, it is the most honorable of souls. وَأَزْكَاهَا, the most purified one. وَأَبَرُّهَا, and the most obedient of them. وَأَبْعَدُهَا مِنْ كُلِّ خُلُقٍ مَدْبُوبٍ. And he is the one who is the furthest from any evil traits and characteristics. وَأَحَقُّهَا بِكُلِّ خُلُقٍ جَمِيلٍ. And he is the one who is most befitting for every good characteristics that is out there. وَمَعَ هَذَا, with all of that, فَلَمْ يَكُنْ يَنْتَقِمُ لَهَا, he never took revenge for himself. فَكَيْفَ يَنْتَقِمُ أَحَدُنَا لِنَفْسِهِ. So then how could one of us take revenge for himself? الَّتِي هُوَ أَعْلَمُ بِهَا. How could one of us take revenge for himself when you truly know that which is within your soul? مِنَ الشُّرُورِ, in terms of its evil. وَالْعُيُوبِ, and shortcomings that your soul has. How are you going to take revenge for it when you know how evil it is and how much shortcomings your soul has? Rather, بَلِ الرَّجُلِ الْعَارِفِ, rather, the man who truly knows and understands, لَا تُسَاوِي نَفْسُهُ عِنْدَهُ The one who truly knows himself, who is smart, he knows that his soul is not equal to any revenge that should be taken for him. In other words, he does not see his soul deserving of a revenge.
وَلَا قَدَرَ لَهَا عِنْدَهُ يُوجِبُ عَلَيْهِ انتصاره لها.
And it has no status to him that necessitates for him to bring his soul a victory. So the smart person is the one who knows his shortcomings very well, and he knows his mistakes, and he knows that his soul is not one that deserves a retaliation or revenge. لا. And this, wallahi, in the beginning of the Sheikh's statement, is that he brought you the Prophet as an example. And we are commanded in the Quran, as Allah says, لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُصْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ لِمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُ اللَّهَ وَالْيَوْمَ الْآخِرَ وَذَكَرَ اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا. For verily, in the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is a good example for whoever hopes for Allah and the Day of Judgment and remembers Allah tabarak wa ta'ala a lot. The Messenger, the best person, the greatest individual who ever walked on this earth, alayhi salatu wasalam, the most purified person, who had the highest station, who has the highest station, he never took revenge for himself. And this is the hadith in Sahih al-Bukhari and Muslim, and the wording is the wording of Al-Imam al-Bukhari. من حديث عائشة رضي الله تعالى عنها, that the Prophet said, Aisha said, sorry, من تقم رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم لنفسه في شيء يؤتى إليه حتى ينتهك من حرمات الله فينتقم لله. Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, she said, the Messenger never took revenge for himself in a matter, لنفسه في شيء يؤتى إليه. The Prophet never took revenge for himself in a matter until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's boundaries that he set is broken. فَيَنْتَقِبُ لِلَّهِ, will take revenge for Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Anyone who reads the Prophet's biography will realize that he never took revenge for himself. Rather, he never got angry for himself. Even though he, salawatullahi wa salamun alayhi, udhiya, he was harmed many times. If you read his siratul atira, you will never see annahu intaqama li nafsihi qattun. He never took any revenge for himself. So for you, one of the things that will help you is what? To be patient upon the harm that the people put you through is, you look at the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam's biography, and you ponder and you analyze, and you strive and you fight to be one who follows his footsteps, salawatullahi wasalamu alayhi. At-tasi'u, number 9. The Shaykh says, rahimahullah, in udhiya ala ma fa'alahu lillah. So this point, inshallah ta'ala, the Shaykh is going to speak about this one, so we have an understanding proper before I translate it, is that the creation's harm to you, it happens in three ways. And the Shaykh mentions those three. The first one is that the people harm you because of a religious issue for your religion. You're calling them to the good, you're prohibiting them from evil, you're doing da'wah to them. Then the Shaykh's going to tell us how to deal with that. The second one is that you are harmed because of some evil which you came with. Then the Shaykh rahimahullah ta'ala tells us how to deal with it then. The third one is you are being oppressed, and harm has you've been inflicted with harm from the creation based on a worldly issue, which is not necessarily haram. Okay? And then how do you deal with it then? Those are the three, and the Shaykh rahimahullah tells us what to do in those situations. So let's mention the first one, and then the second one, and then the third one. He says, and all of them are in the ninth one. He says, in udhiya ala ma fa'alahu lillahi, أو على ما أمر به من طاعته ونهي عنه من معصيته وجب عليه الصبر ولو لم يكن له الانتقام فإنه قد أوذي في الله فأجره على الله. The Shaykh says, if you are being harmed in something you are doing for the sake of Allah, or something you were commanded to do and you were doing it because Allah commanded you to do it and you were following His command, and somebody harms you because of that, or you were staying away from something you were prohibited from because Allah told you to stay away from it, but then you get harmed because of that. وَجَبَ عَلَيْهِ الصَّبْرُ It is obligatory for you to be patient. وَلَمْ يَكُلْ لَهُ الْإِنْتِقَامَ And it is not permissible for you to take revenge on this one. And you cannot take retaliation. Why? فَإِنَّهُ قَدْ أُوذِيَ فِي اللَّهِ Because you are harmed for the sake of Allah. Because you are upon the path of Allah, that's why you're harmed. فَأَجْرُهُ عَلَى اللَّهِ Your reward is with Allah. And then the Shaykh gives you a powerful evidence for this. He says, وَلِهَذَا And because of that, لَمَّا كَانَ الْمُجَاهِدُونَ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ Those who are fighting in the cause of Allah, when they lost their blood, I mean they died, ذَهَبَتْ دِمَاؤُهُمْ وَأَمْوَالُهُمْ فِي اللَّهِ They got killed, and their wealth got distributed and taken. لَمْ تَكُنْ مَضْمُونَةً لَمْ تَكُنْ مَضْمُونَةً There was no guarantee placed on it. In Islam, when these people kill a Muslim in a battle and they're fighting, if that person repents from this act and becomes a Muslim, we won't say to him, you killed a Muslim person, so we're going to kill you for it. This blood of the Mujahid is not guaranteed for a soul for a soul. It's not a nafs to be nafs. Why? فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ اشْتَرَى مِنْهُمْ أَنفُسُهُمْ أَمْوَالُهُمْ Allah bought his soul from him and Allah bought his wealth from him. فَالثَّمَنُ عَلَى اللَّهِ لَا عَلَى الْخَلْقِ So the money is upon Allah تبارك وتعالى, not upon the creation. فَمَنْ طَلَبَ الثَّمَنَ مِنْهُمْ You are, the mujahid is in a trading with Allah. And if you request, who is the one who bought your nafs from you? Who's the one who's going to give you the money for it? Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whoever goes and then asks the creation for it. لَمْ يَكُلْ لَهُ عَلَى اللَّهِ ثَمَنُ Then remember, you have no money with Allah, tabarak wa ta'ala. Because Allah bought it from you, your nafs. You see? Pay attention here. Powerful. Allah tells us, subhanahu wa ta'ala, that the mujahid who's fighting in his cause, Allah brought his nafs from him and his amwal. When you buy something, what do you do? Huh? I take your product and I give you money in return. So the mujahid lost his nafs. So Allah took his nafs from him. So where's the thaman? The thaman is Jannah. Because Allah says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ اشْتَرَى مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ أَنفُسَهُمْ وَأَمْوَالَهُمْ بِأَنَّ لَهُمُ الْجَنَّةِ The thaman here is Jannah. If retaliation is taken on his behalf, then he's asked the thaman from other than Allah. When it was from Allah that he should have got it. So for example, the mujahid loses his wealth. He's still alive, but he loses his wealth. And his wealth gets destroyed in the battlefield. And then because of that, he tries to take retaliation for his wealth and tries to regain his wealth. Then he here should have waited for Allah tabarak wa ta'ala to give it to him. Because Allah says to him, إِنَّ اللَّهَ اشْتَرَى مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ أَنفُسَهُمْ وَأَمْوَالَهُمْ بِأَنَّ لَهُمُ الْجَنَّةِ You already exchanged it for Jannah. So you shouldn't ask anyone for it. You should be patient for Jannah, the day of judgment when it comes. You see, فَإِنَّهُ مَنْ كَانَ فِي اللَّهِ تَلَفَهُ كَانَ عَلَى اللَّهِ خَلَفَهُ Anyone who loses anything in the cause of Allah, then Allah will exchange it for him in something else. Pay attention. So this is the person who's calling to the good. He's like the mujahid. This is a jihad that you're in. So when you get harmed, when you get
put through hardship. فَاصْبِرْ كَمَا صَبَرَ أُولُو الْعَزْمِ مِنَ الرُّسُلِ. Be patient like the messengers, the Ulul Azm, the five chosen prophets. The way they were patient, be patient like that. And endure this suffering for the cause of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, for his religion. That's the first one. It's the first harm that the creation put you through for the sake of this religion. The second one is, وَإِن كَانَ قَدْ أُوذِيَ عَلَى مُصِيبَةٍ. But if you are harmed because of a kalam, because of a mischief, a musiba that came from you, فَلْيَرْجِعْ, then go back to yourself, below me in blame. عَلَى نَفْسِهِ وَيَكُونَ فِي لَوْمِهِ لَهُ شُغْلٌ عَلَى لَوْمِهِ لِمَنْ أَذَاهُ. And make and preoccupy your time with blaming yourself, then preoccupy yourself in blaming those who harmed you. Because this one is what Allah says in an ayah before. وَمَا أَصَابَكُمْ مِنْ مُصِيبَةٍ. There is no trials and tribulations and a calamity that befalls on you, except it is what? فَبِمَا كَسَبَتْ أَيْدِيكُمْ وَيَعْفُ عَنْ كَثِيرًا. The third one is, وَإِنْ كَانَ قَدْ أُوذِيَ عَلَى حَظٍ. And if you are then harmed because of a worldly issue, حظ من حضوض الدنيا, فَلْيُوَطِّن نَفْسَهُ عَلَى الصَّبْرِ, then exercise your soul upon patience. فَإِنِّي لَا الْحُضُوذِ دُونَهُ أَمْرٌ أَمَرُّ مِنَ الصَّبْرِ فَمَنْ لَمْ يَصْبِرْ عَلَى حَرِّ الْهَوَاجِرِ وَالْأَمْطَارِ وَالثُّلُوجِ وَمَشَقَّةِ الْأَسْفَارِ وَلُصُوصِ الطَّرِيقِ وَإِلَّا فَلَا حَاجَةَ لَهُ فِي الْمُتَاجَرَةِ. The Shaykh Khiman here mentions, if you are being harmed because of a worldly issue, then be patient upon it. Because remember, a person who does not show patience on what? The heat, okay? The rain, the ice and the cold weather, and the hardship of traveling from one land to another land, then you are really not ready to trade, are you? You show patience for that. Then the Sheikh says, then the believer has more rights for you to be patient with him. وَهَذَا أَمْرُ مَعْلُومَ عِنْدَ النَّاسِ أَنَّ مَنْ صَدَقَ فِي طَلَبِ شَيْءٍ مِنَ الْأَشْيَاءِ بَذَلَ مِنَ الصَّبْرِ فِي تَحْصِيلِهِ بِقَدْرِ صِدْقِهِ فِي طَلَبِهِ. The Sheikh says, this is a known matter. That a person, this is a known matter, that a person who is truthful in his quest in something, in his love and his passion for his work, you see, he loves his job, then this person, you see that he gives a lot of patience towards everything that comes his way. And the patience is in accordance to his passion and love for his job. So if that's the case for a job and a worldly matter, you will show that patience for it, then your brother is more befitting. Your Muslim brother, for you to be patient for him for a worldly reason, is more befitting. Number 10. أَيَشْهَدَ, that you bear witness. مَعِيَّةَ اللَّهِ, that Allah is with you. إِذَا صَبَرَ, if you show patience. وَمَحَبَّةَ اللَّهِ لَهُ, and Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's love for you. إِذَا صَبَرَ, if you show patience. وَرِضَاهُ, that Allah is pleased with you. وَمَنْ كَانَ اللَّهُ مَعَهُ, and anyone who Allah is with him. دَفَعَ عَنْهُ أَنْوَاعَ الْأَذَى, Allah will repel from you all types of hardship and harm. والمضرات, all types of hardship and harms and calamities and pain and agony. ما لا يدفع عنه أحد من خلقي. He will repel it from you. He will defend it from you. That which no creation can defend from you. قال الله تعالى, Allah says, واصبر, be patient. إن الله مع الصابرين, Allah is with those who are patient. الله أكبر. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is with the one who is patient. And this ma'iyyah is ma'iyyatun khasa. It's not the general type of ma'iyyah. The ma'iyyah, two types, as Ibn Rajab mentions in his Jam' Ulum wal Hikam. That Allah is with you here. Allah is with you. The ma'iyatul khasa means what? بالتأييد والنصر. Victory and help, Allah is with you. Not only that, وقال تعالى, Allah also says, والله يحب الصابرين. Allah loves those who are patient. Allah loves those who are patient. So Allah loves you, subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you gain the love of Allah. And we all know, my beloved brothers and sisters, the matter is not that you love Allah. ليس الشأن أن تحب ولكن الشأن كل الشأن أن تحب. The matter is not that you love Allah. The truth of the matter is that He loves you in return. Because we can all love, but what really matters is that we're loved in return. So you gain the love of Allah by being patient. That's what you gain.